There was a terrorist attack at a mosque right here in Bloomington back in August. It was national news then. Well, last week, after a few tips, a few warrants, and a confession from one of the suspects, three men were arrested for that bombing, accused of driving all the way from southeast Illinois to target this mosque so these Muslims would be intimidated. Tonight, I sat down with the executive director of the Islamic Center. We had lots of questions for him. He also had a lot of questions himself.
One of them smashed the window. Smashed the window, and another guy threw the bomb into this room, into where we're standing right now, and the bomb exploded.
It was August 5th, last year, about 5 in the morning. Muhammad Omar, the Dar Al-Farooq executive director, was in a neighboring office, others preparing for prayer across the hall. According to a criminal complaint, Michael Hari waited in a getaway truck. Joe Morris smashed the window with a sledgehammer, and Michael McWhorter threw the homemade bomb into the office of the imam. No one was hurt, at least physically. Months later, the complaint says two confidential sources sent the sheriff's office in Ford County, Illinois, and the FBI pictures of bomb-making materials at Hari's parents' house, that along with a cache of automatic and semi-automatic rifles. According to the complaint, one source told the FBI that these three men were responsible for the bombing in Bloomington, as well as an attempted bombing at a women's clinic in Illinois months later. During an interview, McWhorter eventually admitted their involvement to investigators, according to the complaint.
In the report, the man who admitted to investigators to throwing a bomb through that window said that they did not intend to kill anyone, but they wanted to, quote, scare them out of the country. What's your reaction to that?
It threw a bomb and the device itself kills. He drove 600 miles just to scare us? That doesn't make sense. What if the building got fired and everybody inside dies?
So what would you like these three guys who are accused of doing this, and anybody else who wants to judge you before they've met you, what would you like them to know?
We are human beings too. Yes, we are different, but our difference shouldn't be a reason that why I got, you know, hurt or I got killed or I got marginalized. If you want to know about Islam, ask a Muslim. If you want to know about Somali person, ask a Somali. But don't judge me based on what you hear from the news media.
Omar said since the bombing, his wife will not allow his children to walk one block to the mosque. He says the bomb is one thing to deal with. Why the bomb was planted is another.
It's not only the bomb we're dealing with. You just go to the school, a young daughter who cannot, you know, feel safe because she wear hijab. She look different. When a young boy who wanted to play with his peer, because his name, they make fun of him. I mean, that's the society that we're dealing with. On top of that, somebody want to bomb you? So what would be the question?
So a great piece of journalism from the Star Tribune, Stephen Montemayor, says the three men were part of the White Rabbits 3% Illinois Patriot Freedom Fighters. It's a local militia group there. The supposed leader, Hari, he's a former Ford County Sheriff's deputy, actually, who was fired in 1997, according to that report, and claimed that protesting at Branch Davidian in Texas in 1993, we know how that turned out, he was there apparently protesting, that he says galvanized his beliefs.
Oh, yeah, and if you read Stephen's piece in the Star Tribune, you want to check it out, I just retweeted it. I mean, the laundry list of what that man has done, that Mr. Hari, mm-hmm. and his racist ideology and his Islamophobia, mm-hmm. dates back for decades. The stuff doesn't just come out of a vacuum. It's bred online, and it festers over time. The one thing that we don't really know for certain, right, Chris, is why that mosque? Why Minnesota?
So we don't know yet. Right. It doesn't say anywhere in the criminal complaint. The investigators don't say it. But, I mean, they theorize that there were complaints put out online in blogs from people in the area. There's some people at the mosque who say this. And that other groups, perhaps alt-right groups, other websites that are bigger, picked them up and said, look what's happening here. But I can't corroborate that. It doesn't say they were anywhere in the investigation yet.
It's just a long way to go for that kind of activity.
It's sad. And you know what? It brought a lot of great people out, too, he says. Omar said that they didn't know they had so many friends in their local community,
yeah,
who helped rebuild that very office.
Right. Yeah, I checked back in with them just about 3 months after the bombing and said the same thing. But that sad truth remains.
that families still aren't comfortable bringing their kids there because they're scared.